Thank you. Good morning, Chairman and Co-Chairman. Ladies and gentlemen, today I will present my research. The topic is, can compression stocking reduce incident hypotension during hip flexor surgery? Hip flexor is a common problem. More than half have many underlying diseases. This leads to disability and excessive mortality. Hypotension during surgery is a common problem that leads to serious complications, and almost every case has ended up to surgery. Evidence of hypotension during hip flexor surgery is real. In this table, show prevalence of hypotension is very high, almost 40%. And what is factor can cause intraoperative hypotension? About patient, elderly, multiple comorbidity, poor physiologic baseline. About fracture has many blood loss. About anesthesia, general anesthesia or under spinal block. This lead to intraoperative hypotension that end up serious complication. And how to prevent hypotension during surgery? After you use spinal block, that block sympathetic and cause peripheral vasodilate, and then finally cause hypotension. And this is compression stocking. It can increase venous return to heart and can disrupt vasodilate and finally reduce hypotension during surgery. In my literature review, in this paper show case elective cesarean section under spinal block, divide patient in two groups. One is leg lapping and another one is control group. Then looking for incident of hypotension. In this paper can conclude leg lapping can reduce hypotension. But limitation of previous study, the difference of people of cesarean section group and hip flexor group, because hip flexor group have older and multiple comorbidity and no clearly guidelines such as pressure, timing and method, and no evidence based can prove. My objective is compare incident rate of hypotension during hip flexor surgery between two groups are use and no use compression stocking. Methodology is unbiased. Randomized control trial, box randomization use program SATA. Research in Ramathibodi Hospital, about 1 year. This is example compression stocking. We apply one leg contralateral flexor site, and then we operate patient. This is inclusion criteria are following. In the right side of the table, patient hip flexor aged more than 60, under spinal block and accept informed consent. And in the right side of the table is exclusion criteria about peripheral vascular disease, neuropathy, cellulitis, or deep vein thrombosis. We use data of previous study and calculate sample size by N4 study. In this study, 30 people each group, total 60 people. And data collection is baseline characteristics about age, gender, underlying diagnosis, site and operation, and clinical data. We record medication, peri-operation, blood pressure, blood loss, hypotension, and complication. And outcome measurement, primary outcome is incident rate of intraoperative hypotension and postoperative hypotension. And secondary outcome is incident rate of complication during hip flexor surgery and postoperative surgery. In statistical analysis, we use chi-square, t-test, Mann-Whitney U-test. This is my result. When patient hip flexor come to Lama Thibodaux Hospital, we have accrued patient that has accretion criteria first. Before surgery, we will randomize patient into group. 30 patients for each group. One is use compression stocking, and another one is control group. Each group monitor blood pressure, and then we will looking for incidence of hypotension inter and post-operative between two group. About baseline characteristics, such as age, gender, diagnosis, site, operation, were not significant difference between two group. And outcome, such as inter and post-operative hypotension, ephedrine use, and blood loss were not significant difference between two group. But if concomitant inter-operative and post-operative compression stocking reduce significant this incident. And about complication, there was no significant difference in the incident complication between two groups. In total number of cases, there was no significant difference in total number of cases between two groups, but the control group has more higher than compression stocking group. About discussion and perioperative hypotension, significant difference in proportion of hip flexor patient who concomitant inter and post-operative hypotension. Compression stocking might be benefit for post-operative hemodynamic control. And about perioperative complication, the compression stocking group show lower, but not significant in perioperative compression than control group. Stand of my study is randomized control trial with intention to treat analysis and can complete data record in every patient. But limitation of my study, perform only one center and instrument bias from small leg some patient, and we cannot record cardiac output and venous return real. In my conclusion, compression stocking has ability to prevent concomitant inter and post-operative hypotension and might prevent hypotension-related perioperative complication. But however, the last prospective is required. Thank you.